Various changes are taking place in her. To understand them, we must start at the beginning of the story. In the farmyard, you can see how baby chicks grow into pullets and cockerels, which before long become adult fowls. You can also see how calves become heifers, and heifers grow up into cows. It's the same with humans. Babies become children, and in time, children become adults, grown-up men and women. Between childhood and being grown up, there's a period called adolescence, when the bodies of boys and girls are adapting themselves to this change. Adolescence means becoming adult. Here's a group of adolescents. Among them is Mary. And here's her mother, an adult woman. Growing up doesn't happen overnight. It's a gradual process which takes place in girls between the ages of 11 and 15. Nature is getting these girls ready to be able to have babies themselves when they're grown up. But let's go back to the farmyard a moment. When the pullet becomes an adult hen, she lays eggs. So do all mother birds and fishes and reptiles. These eggs have some sort of shell or skin to protect the babies inside them. But animals, such as the cow and the human, don't lay their eggs. Instead, the eggs develop into babies inside their body, where they're warm and well protected, and where they can feed and grow until the time comes for them to be born. To get ready for this important job of motherhood, a girl's body has to change in various ways. This 11-year-old has still got the straight figure of a tall child. But at 13, Mary's age, the breasts begin to develop, the hips broaden, and the legs grow stronger. At 15, a girl is almost fully developed, with narrow waist, broad hips, and strong legs. This means that she'll be able to have babies when the time comes. While these changes are taking place, the reproductive system inside her body is developing too. Here are the uterus, or womb, the ovaries, one on each side of the body, and the fallopian tubes which connect them. The ovaries are about the size and shape of walnuts. Each contains thousands of eggs, minute as a speck of dust, of which only a few hundred ever mature. Once a month, an egg in one of the ovaries does mature, and it starts on a journey to the uterus. When it's ready, it pushes through the walls of the ovary, and the fine fingers at the entrance of the tube guide it in. The tubes are from 3 to 5 inches long, and it takes the egg about 8 days to reach the uterus. The uterus is a small pouch, shaped like a pear upside down. While the egg's still traveling along the tube, the lining of the uterus swells with an extra supply of blood ready for its arrival. This is to feed the egg, should it have become fertilized by meeting a sperm or male cell. If it is fertilized, the egg will attach itself to the lining and begin to develop. The walls of the uterus are muscular and elastic, so that it can stretch to many times its normal size and hold a growing baby. Now, what happens when the egg isn't fertilized? There's no further need for it in the uterus, and so it disperses, and it passes out of the body by way of the vagina, which leads from the uterus. The thickened lining of the uterus walls is no longer of any use either, so it too dissolves and leaves the body by way of the vagina. The vagina, you realize, opens downwards between the water passage, called the urethra, and the back passage, called the rectum. Once a month, the process repeats itself. Let's watch it again. About a week after the end of each period, an egg matures and leaves the ovary. It enters the tube straight away, and it takes about 8 days to travel along to the uterus. Meanwhile, the blood vessels in the lining of the uterus walls are preparing a rich supply of extra blood feed the egg should it have become fertilized by a male cell. If it is fertilized, it attaches itself to the lining of the uterus walls, and grows into a baby. If it isn't fertilized, it disperses and passes out through the vagina. There's no need for the extra supply of blood lining the uterus walls. So, about the 28th day, it too passes out of the body by way of the vagina. Getting rid of this waste matter from the uterus is called menstruation, a word which comes from the Latin for month. It lasts for a period of 3 to 5 days and is often called the period. Menstruation usually starts between the ages of 12 and 14, though individuals vary. Some girls may start earlier, others later. It takes place regularly in every normal woman until no more egg cells mature in the ovaries, which happens round about 45 to 50. It's part of growing up into a woman who will one day be able to have children of her own. It's a perfectly normal and natural process, and not an illness. Mary is just starting on a menstrual period, so she's feeling a bit tired and she's glad to get home and relax. She looks at her diary to see the date. It's May the 1st. She can expect her next period to begin on May the 29th, 4 weeks later. But at first, it may not be regular, as the different parts of the body may not have got used to working together as a team. There's nothing to worry about, even if the interval is a matter of months. It will soon establish itself in a regular cycle of about 28 days from the start of one period to the start of the next. During the period, sanitary pads must be worn to prevent soiling clothes. More pads are needed at the beginning of the period than towards the end. It's essential to change them often for hygienic reasons and to prevent the skin from being chafed. They should be changed night and morning and whenever possible during the day. Soil pads should be wrapped in paper at once and burnt, or else put into the proper receptacle provided for them. Pads without the lavatory pan. When you're buying pads, it's important to choose the right size, an individual matter. Mary finds that the smallest size, O, is most comfortable, and it gives her adequate protection. The average number of pads needed by most girls is one packet a month, but some need more. The amount of flow varies at different periods and in different people. Pads can be secured to your suspender belt or attached to a sanitary belt, which is safer and more comfortable. If a period is very heavy, or if it lasts for more than 5 days, or if it brings severe pain, it's a good thing to consult a doctor. The shop's closing, but Mary won't be caught unprepared as she's bought her next month's packet. It's important to wash often during the period. You can have a bath, though not a cold one, as you don't want to catch a chill. If your skin has become chafed through not being able to change pads during the day, dust yourself with talcum powder after washing and rub in some boracic ointment or cold cream. Normally, you shouldn't get chafed at all. So, with comfortable pads to wear and simple health rules to follow, the monthly period needn't be so very inconvenient. Don't worry if you feel slack or lazy. Menstruation sometimes has that effect while it lasts. Mary decides to go to bed earlier than usual and get some extra sleep. Avoiding constipation helps too. You can do this by drinking plenty of water and by eating brown bread, fruit, and vegetables. The ideal is to aim at a regular motion at the same time each day. You should try to keep your feet dry. That's all very well, but what about wet days? The answer is to take off your wet shoes and stockings as soon as you can, when you get home or when you arrive at school, and change into dry ones. Washing your hair is perfectly all right, provided you dry it thoroughly afterwards. You must avoid getting a cold. Swimming? Well, it's as well to put off your swim till the period's over, because the cold water might give you a chill. But you can dance. You can cycle as usual, to school or in the country. You can play hockey or any other game, provided you feel like it. Some girls do and some don't. There's no hard and fast rule. Just do as much as you feel you can do. That's far the best plan. It's not unusual to have some discomfort in the first 2 days of a period. Try to ignore it. But just see if there's a hot drink going. At the end of the period, your body has got rid of the material it no longer needs. You'll find you've more energy than you had just before it began, and you'll feel fine.